How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Grim Scavenger Pro, and today I'm about to teach you a little something about paladins. And this is how to be a god tier Viktor and Andros, or Androxus, as his full name goes. So, more or less, if you play Overwatch, this is basically the Russian Soldier 76, and the basically cultist version of McCree, with a sexier trench coat than a fucking poncho, shoulder cape thing, whatever he has. Anyway, let's start off with Viktor, because Viktor's way more straightforward and way more powerful to you know, people who are shit at this game. The strength of the team is each member. And, of course, Viktor ain't lying when he says that. Yep, exactly. So here you can see my deck. Take a nice hard look at that. Alright, good. Now that you got that out of the way, you know how I build them. I'm building them for ADS, for movement speed, and for using those grenades a lot. Of course, I'm getting health on kill because I've fallen in love with it compared to the fandangled lifesteal drain every hit because it just gives me a lot more fucking health. I mean, 30% of, like 10% of like 600 damage is like 60 health. I think that, yeah, it's like 60 health, but like I get a kill, 300 health instantly. Like I'm okay with that. I'd rather get that because I play flank heroes. I play heroes that don't have a lot of health that are trying to get kills actively. Ergo, any heal is good heals, and especially burst heal. Burst heal is the best heal, in my opinion. But that's just how I roll. Anyway, so yeah. Now I'm gonna walk you through this mindset. All right. So imagine it's like sort of like how a spy thinks by Mr. Paladin. All right. So, more or less, what you want to do is you want to aim for the squishies. That is your priority. You are not an assassin target, but the more open and exposed motherfuckers, those are the ones you want to aim for. Then you want to gun down their tank, especially their less aggressive tank, their retreaters. You want to shoot the cowards in the back. Why? Because they do not honor battle, ergo, deserters get shot. You know, World War One mentality. Deserters get shot. You definitely want to focus down on a Grok. A Grok is a combat medic. This guy will shred your health bar, he will rip your asshole apart, and then he will shoot lightning up it. Alright? And same thing with Andros. Andros will do the exact same thing. You know, here you can see I just banked that grenade. You know, always remember trajectories, geometry, such and such. You know? And here's the reason why you want to keep geometry in mind. Like Hanzo's scatter arrow, it gets the kills. Trust me. It gets the kills. I've banked a grenade off three different walls once and got a Fernando killed because he was hiding behind his shield at low health. Now, also, you want to keep in mind headshots. Headshots are king. Yeah, like I said, Andros, he'll rip you apart. He gets his flank on, he'll rip you apart. As you can see by my build, I am focusing heavily on my ADS. Why? Because I have a legendary card, which is the default legendary card, that just gives you more damage when you're ADSing. It's efficient. I like it. It works. And, you know, because of the fact that it just works. Like, King Crimson, it's pretty fucking good. But it just works. Anyway. So, yeah, you want a PTFO. See, unlike her, you want to get in on that action. You want to keep your distance. And then, of course, when you pop your ult, you want to aim for clusters. It doesn't matter if they're hiding behind a shield. It doesn't matter if they're hiding under a ceiling. The bomb just spawns above their head. That's just that. All right? It just spawns right there. And that's it. And so what you want to do is bomb them. Bomb the fuck out of them. Especially since they're being idiots. And me, I am not being aware during this gameplay. But of course, you will see me clutch it out pretty hard. This is about the last death you see in, like, almost the entire match. Like, I only die three times this whole match. So the next death ain't for a while. If I am remembering this right. I just played this, like, probably 30 minutes ago now. Anyway. So, yes. Of course. What you want to do is, even though you're not a flanker, you are the lone wolf, so you have to flank. You know, you have to be out there. You're one-man army. You know, you're John fucking Rambo, but the thing is, you're not unkillable. You just hit really hard. Well, you hit a lot. You don't hit hard. You hit a lot. Now, you want to focus down on the Andros. I get lag killed there. As you could tell, that was a lag kill. He popped his old Defiance, which is the 3-round burst of the revolver. He fans the hammer, and that did the 800 damage that did me in. Of course, what you want to do, what you mainly want to focus on, of course, Viktor's abilities, if you don't know, simple logic. He has a grenade, a sprint, an ADS, and then his ultimate is a mortar strike. Anyway, so, yeah, what you want to focus on mainly is shooting people in the fucking face. I'm not even joking when I say that. Shoot them in the face. Shoot at the totem. See that health totem? That would heal him. Boom. Not healed anymore. Oh, you got health? Well, fuck you. That's my mentality. Fuck you. Shoot, throw a grenade at him. You know, similar to Grok, very similar to a god tier Grok, you have to use your utility ability a lot. And his utility ability is frags, and Grok's is the lightning bolt. And this is just, I love this one. It's my favorite. I didn't get any guns, any skins out of that chest, but I got that fucking emote, and I love it. So yeah. I'm sorry, I love that thing. Anyway, so yeah, more or less, what you want to do whenever you're in an encounter, whenever you're doing anything with Viktor, what you want to look for is flaws. I mean, you could say that with any champion, you want to look for flaws, but with assassin, with DPS assassins and burst, just assassin heroes period, DPS or burst, you want to look for the weakness, especially in Viktor because it's sustained fire. Those who run or those who are in a channel, aggro the channeler, aggro the healer, you know, aggro those who are weak, who are like currently about to get like their ass smashed, like that, like watch. See, I'm not shooting at the Fernando, I'm shooting at the Bomb King. I'm shooting at this guy who's aggroed another person. He's distracted, he's not paying attention. Now see, I'm not paying attention here, but I pull it out, dude. Military. Alright, you run your ass away from things. In a way, you are the most on. In a way, you are the executioner of the cowards, but at the same time, you are the king of cowards, because you tend to run away from a lot of your fights to get your health back. It's just, you know, regeneration. Of course, everyone in this game has regeneration. If you didn't fucking know this already, you get out of combat, everyone can just regenerate health. It's just sort of a thing. It's great. I love it. So yeah. Now watch, see Fernando, boom, shoot him in the face, doesn't know what the fuck he's doing, doesn't know anything, doesn't know what's going on. If you want a tip, don't build Nimble like I did on Viktor, because it's pointless, because you have Sprint. And if you built a card that gives you more movement speed when ADSing, then you also Nimble, again, is useless, it's redundant. Boom, see, saw him coming around the corner. Now watch this, gonna hit it, gonna bank it off, boom, hit him in the back. Now he's turning around, he's looking at me, my whole team's behind him, my whole team's going to take care of that ass. Now, see, I'm jumping around because Bomb King is like a sticky spamming demo man from TF2. You gotta jump. See, now he's paying attention to the team. Boom, now he's dead. Now, Grok, he ain't paying attention. I'm just laying into him. He's ghost walking, but watch. Perfect timed grenade. Jumped back. He thought that grenade was about to kill him, but I got the timing off so he would stop himself. Runs into a bush, shoot him in the ass. Simple logic. Now, if there's one thing you want to keep in mind, never, ever pop your ult unless you have a clear line of sight. As for me, I had to wait a hot minute, but I was able to pop it off. Sadly, I did not get a kill, but I got burst damage. That burst damage led to their downfall. Because of that downfall, I was able to move in and take them out. Because, well, I burst their health down. Now I'm focusing on the Grok. Okay, Grok stood still. Never stand still when there's a Viktor nearby. Keep moving. Alright, that's the counter him. Now, Fernando. Fernando's your deadliest enemy, because you don't have a lot of health, and that's a flamethrower. But, hey, I just shot him to death. So what does it matter? This guy was a dumbass. Alright, I got a 15 kill streak right now. Now, this is probably one of my biggest kill streaks in this game, alright? Almost any game, like, this is one of my biggest kill streaks. I mean, except for Black Ops 2, I got like a 35 kill streak once. Back when I bought it the second time, but that's not the point. The point is that this here is truly, you know, not... This is a pretty good gameplay, but the reason why this is so damn good is not because I'm some Adderall popping fucking ADD little shit. No, it's because I know how to play other heroes, and because of his low barrier of entry, I can use my Andro technique on him, which is essentially look around, like, you know, move in, and while you're moving, just constantly look around, turn your head left right, always keep your eyes open. See me? I didn't keep my eyes open. And that's what I get. I get shot in the ass a little bit. This Andrew watch. He's going to turn around. He's going to try to fake me out. No. And he's going to try running away. But then he's going to watch. Now watch and learn, because I'm going to clutch this out like a motherfucker. All right. Looking around. Not aware. Seen our sky run away. Boom. Shoot him in the ass. Can't keep an eye on him. Can't keep track. This is what I'm talking about. How you counter him. Throw a grenade. Miss entirely. But then shoot him, luckily. Thank God I shot him. Now you hear that, you retreat. See, like me, I saw the missile fly by, I'm like, fuck no, I'm out of that situation real quick. But I know to hit the Chandler. Chandler has low health, boom, down. Alright, now aim for the medic. Always go for the medic. Never go for a frontliner as long as they're a medic. That's weaker than the frontliner, because you'll be able to kill that medic pretty damn quickly. They don't have a lot of health. Boom, took him down. Pretty simple, pretty easy logic, right? Yeah, alright, this is a stun grenade, essentially. The bomb, the fucking grumpy bomb. Alright, that will stun you. That will lock you in place if you were unaware. If you are aware of this, then you know why I hide there. Alright, annihilation. That might as well be a godlike. I don't think there is anything past the 15 killing spree. But I don't know, because I've never gotten a 20 straight killing spree. If you notice the kills I got, some of those are technically assists, hence why they didn't count towards the streak. Because the streak system's very bizarre in the sense that it counts every 15 kills, but yet you can have like 20 kills and have a 15 killing spree. Technically speaking, you'll have like the 15 pop up. See, me? Made a mistake. Made a huge mistake here. Popped up my ult without even seeing the target. Thank God I moved in quickly. And because of the quick moving technique, I was able to pull it out nice and clutchy-like. And yeah, clutchy. Because it was sort of clutch or not. Clutch. Alright, Grumpy Bomb. Watch. Now look closely. This is your bane of your fucking existence. Like any sniper, like any sticky spam from TF2, which by the way, I'm a demo main and I don't sticky spam, but... I understand sticky spam well, because being a demo main, you have to understand it. And understanding that the ult on Bomb King is truly some of the hardest shit to take care of, because you may not get a hit on him. He might be bobbing and weaving in and out of cover with that ult. Or he might just not be in your sight. Now watch. I have this much health. Watch me. Max health kills me instantly. Instantly. It's a rip tire from Overwatch, essentially. It is a rip tire that will fuck you up. And especially if you're an Androx, because Androx has less health than Viktor. He has 200 less health. So, yeah. Essentially, in essence, you are, you can be one-shotted by a fuck ton of things. You can die very, very quickly. And if you are not mobile and you just walk down the road ADSing and shooting, you're going to get your ass killed. Me, luckily, I was able to walk away, and then after a short time, that sticky bomb fell off of me. And this Andro, he's running away. He's trying to coward his way out of this shit. Now watch. Boom. Okay, watch me take on both these guys. Alright, now you'll watch. This streak will instantly climb up. Like, it will climb really hard. And... boom. Watch this. Alright, just drop the just tactical nuke the fucker. Alright, this is the Cold War, and it just went hot, alright? This is how this shit goes. He's aggroing me, but this guy can't aim. He thinks I'm going to go left, but I'm just standing still. That's the thing. You got to fake these guys out by strafing a little. Showing a little footwork. Show a little footwork, they overcompensate. Show no footwork, and they don't compensate at all, and they just keep shooting you right in the face. So you can't trick them out in that sense. So there's a lot of, I don't want to say there's a lot of meta to this guy, but this guy's powerful as fuck. Let's get real. All right? He's one of the most powerful champions in the game, if used correctly. Similar to Androxus, and similar to Lex, which is a hero that has yet to come out on the console. Luckily, I have a PC. I played him a little bit. He's really good, and I will do a comparison video later on of Androxus versus Lex, because they're in the same class. They're both flanks, all right, and they're both very interesting. They both are, in essence, the same and yet different. They are quite literally the not the identical twin, but the maternal twins, in a way. They are, in technicality, they are the same, but yet they are different. Also, if you didn't know, I was actually looking out of the corner of my eye, and I saw his horse ride up over into that bush, and because I saw him ride up into that bush, I aimed at the bush. I knew he was going to be in there. Alright, he's running away. Now watch this. I'm going to bank this grenade right into him. Boom. Got him. I mean, the grenade blew up afterwards, but it still, like, got his attention. Boom. Takedown. Alright. You just gotta keep moving. I mean, you're not gonna pick up solo kills unless you're just gonna shoot Skye in the face like 16 times. Then that will kill her. Yes. Wish Skye is that bitch with that tight ass right there. Alright. He wasted his ult. Boom. Go in there. Get nothing. Get no payout. Although, I can hold back with my team. He's ulting. Then watch. Boom. He's about to ulti. Alright. Yeah. He's invincible. Nope. You're not invincible, bitch. Not anymore. You're down. We're regenerating. And we're almost godlike. Alright. We're god near godlike. Now I'm gonna pop my ult here. Just nuke him. Of course, he's dead. Now I'm going to wait. Nuke. Nuke. And now we win. That was smooth. Silky smooth. And by the way, in case you're wondering, this is how you get play of the game. You be good like this, you'll get play of the game every day. No matter if there's a Skye spamming out is a, her, you know, her like popping ult and then just kill two people. This is how you win right here. Not even with no need for the for Skye. Watch. Boom. Rooted and down. That's it. Simple. You play good, you do good footwork, and you'll win. You'll succeed. Now, see, this is the part where I'm generous right here. Sorry for the moment of silence. But I'm pretty sure you'd appreciate it. Anyway, alright, so this is my setup here. Alright, outside of my cosmetics, I'm going to be using Darkstalker. Darkstalker is probably the best card for Androxus, because it makes him a whole new hero in a way. Now, this is my build. My build is focused heavily on Defiance, which is his right-click, the Fan the Hammer of sorts of this game. Of course, you only shoot three shots, and after when three shots land, you do the 800 damage. Of course, I have Lifesteal on that, and then I have it so every hit of my reversal puts 0.5 seconds off my deflect ability, which is quite good, quite powerful, indubitably. It's undeniable, and it's undenounceable. One of the best moves in anybody's kit is your ult fire. You know, it's supposed to be, it's a very defining feature of your character. Barak, he has his barricades. Drogos has his rocket burst, where he just mag dumps his entire rockets. Cassie, she has, like, I think an explosive arrow. See, with her, it's not that special. With Buck, it's not his leap. It's his regeneration, his health regen. With Maeve, it's her lunge stab. You see, these are very defining features that make them stand out amongst each other in the battlefield. Your alt fire is one of the best. Unlike, you know, Overwatch, it doesn't seem to take that into consideration. An alt fire of sorts. It only on some heroes, which, I mean, in a way is kind of cool. Kind of isn't, though, you know? Anyway. So, yeah. I'm going to just, you know, edit this out right here. Alright, and get ready, and here we are. Jaguar Falls, one of my favorite Siege maps, in all honesty, and one of the best maps for Androxus, one of the worst maps for Drogos, though, especially when you got some excellent aerial denial hit scan heroes like Viktor or Tyra. Of course, as you can see, we're built. You see a Torvald. Here's the thing, alright? I know I'm talking fast, alright? So, obviously, I'm going to pick my great build that I enjoy. Now, here's what you want to build. You either want to build Wrecker on Androxus, Carterize. You never want to build Bulldozer. Bulldozer's no point, because nobody uses deployables. All right, here, I'm trying to show you the spread. The spread is RNG. But every time the first shot is always in the middle. Keep that in mind. The first shot's always in the middle with Defiance. The rest two are just kind of spammed out. They can be any pattern. Of course, you get close enough, that doesn't matter, because the spread kind of, over distance, the spread gets wider, but as you get closer, the spread gets tighter. Makes sense, right? You know? Like, I'm at a pretty close distance, and it's like, the spread is pretty tight. Not straying too far from my reticule, which is actually pretty huge. Well, not huge, it's a pretty good size. Androxus has a nether step. Of course, Darkstalker allows you to use your nether step whenever you want. You can use one nether step, and it's like Tracer's Blinks, essentially. Now watch, see, I'm trying to hit this guy. Couldn't find him. Could not find him because he lagged out. Now this is what you want to do, see? Normally you have a meter telling you, hey, that's a countdown, you can't be doing that. But this is why it's so great, because look, getting hit, oh, I can just do that whenever, and I still got two more charges. And about to have my third charge back. Now, of course, you are a flanker. You're supposed to be flanking. That is your shtick. Of course, since they have a Torvald, I just picked Wrecker so I could shoot through the shield and munch it up with my Defiance 800 damage being multiplied because of Wrecker. It does more damage against shield, so it will add a percentage of the damage that I do onto the shield, basically putting my damage in the thousands against Torvald when he has a shield up, which is pretty good because... Well, you pop two Defiances at close range on him, and you will fucking shred his shit so hard, dude. It's not even funny. Alright? Now watch. This is the thing. People tend to ignore Andros. I don't know why. These guys were pretty daft. Like, in a sense that they didn't... They had, like, excellent, surrounding, but at the same time, they didn't. They were pretty daft with it. See, I'm doing 900. Of course, your normal damage is 600. Now, boom. See, double tap it with the Defiance, and that's how you win a gunfight. Pretty simple. It wasn't really a gunfight since I stuck it to his back and spammed out bullets. It's more of a stick-up, if you will. Of course, here is where things get interesting, because this is an easy place for Pip to shit on me. Pip has an explosive. He has a grenade launcher. That's what he does. And so does Bomb King. My thing is, plain and simply... They can show me in close quarters because their blast doesn't hurt them, it just hurts me, as far as I remember. See, look, bonus damage from Tyra just got me the kill almost instantly. You see, he's not paying attention? This is the problem with not having good game sense. Boom, that shit can come up on you. He's trying to get his shield back. Nope, not gonna let it happen. And I still pick up the kill in the end. At least in some way, shape, or fashion. Healing coming up here, boom. So that was simple, I would say that's a hard read. That was a pretty fucking hard read. Now I'm just gonna pop my ult, alright. I couldn't really find them, and I'm like, okay, where are you? Boom, got the double kill with my ult. See, once if you at least get one kill with your ult, you spent it well, especially on like a high damage hero. But if you get two kills, you spent it at one of the better times, better moments in the game. I will say that as a matter of fact. It is one of the best ways to spend it. Now you look at my credits, I got 1,000. Why? Because I'm just doing really fucking good. Alright, now here's the thing. You can either go with morale boost or nimble. I like his ultimate, so I would go with morale boost normally. But of course, because champions are faster, I'm going to stick with nimble. And I pick Blast because Bomb King and Pip are my biggest issues at the moment. Not Ying, not Shaolin, the arrow guy, and not Torvald, the symmetric guy with the beam. Because they're not hitting me, they're not aggroing me enough. You see, because I am, you know, devil on their back. I am cheap tricks. You know, I'm cheap tricks, you know. I'm on their back, and you show anyone your back, I'm going to kill you. All right? And if you don't know, that was a JoJo reference. And if you don't watch JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, well, I don't know what to fucking tell you. Now, for some reason, my aim just went potato right here. I don't know. Shooting at furries is kind of hard, especially when they're running around in a small square, you know, with very unpredictable movements. I'm gonna probably die here. That's what I think. I'm like, okay, I'm probably gonna die. Oh, shooting arrows at me. Boom, just deflected it back at you, at your friend, you know. Now I'm gonna another step away. Let the heals come back. And now watch. He's getting aggressive. He's getting frisky. All right, they're all getting frisky. They're all getting real ballsy. Tyra just pops her ult. That's infinite ammo plus 40% movement speed plus higher rate of fire. Now I'm going to take out their healer because I know their healer's causing all this shit. She's causing tough shit to happen. She's doing all the bad shit. Now that killed me because she caught me on the bad reload. That's the problem with some of the healers in this game. They are quite powerful. Supports are fucking scary. All right, they will screw you up. I will say Grok is like the Androxus of the support team. All right. He's powerful. And guess what? As you can see from this gameplay, Androxus is pretty fucking scary. Now, thankfully, I have this architecture to hide behind because I was able to pull off that move right there. Now, I have my ult up. All right. Everyone's running away from me. Everyone's, you know, trying to aggro my ass. Boom. Come from death from above. All right. I'm just going to bombard him like it's Pearl Harbor all over again. Except for the difference. I'm not Japanese, and this ain't a racially charged kind of issue. This is just me coming in there, bombing you to prevent reinforcements. To prevent you from having men, so the reinforcements basically are singled out and alone. Like Ying here, she was the reinforcement, she got singled out really quick. As you can see here, you know, I'm obviously taking the standard flank routes, but the difference is I'm going at them. I'm coming at them from the front. They would expect it from the back. I'm coming at them from the front or a side front, rather, you know, an angle. Which is better than coming at them from straight behind, because then one guy's like, hey, Androx is behind, and they all can turn around. But they come at it from the angle, they're like, whoa, Androx is in front of me, and they're like, what do you mean? He's like, they don't know where the fuck I'm at. You know? They don't tend to pick up on things. I mean, then again, a lot of people in this game don't tend to pick up on things, unless you're really hardcore into it. Shooters. Okay, see, I'm trying to escape, I'm trying to hide, I'm trying to make them aim all over the place. And see, I was able to escape? Not quite, though. Not quite. Because Torvald's got range. Alright, he's got a pretty decent amount of range. Now, luckily, I have Wrecker, so I was able to wreck his shit. Plain and simple. Now that I got Nimble up to level 2, I am quite fast. I will bring up the reason why I'm picking Nimble now over Morale Boost. And it's not because I want the more movement speed. No. It's to get used to this alternate playstyle for one of the heroes, the new hero who's coming into the game on the console soon. You gotta get... I'll explain that later, another day. Now watch, see, he's popping his ult. He ain't paying attention to me. I back up because I think he's about to instantly kill me. Nope. He blows up. Now watch. Alright, idiot. Guy was an absolute fool. I was silenced. Doesn't matter. Okay, he ults on me. Doesn't matter. I'm a flying champion. I can, you know, use my vertical movement and horizontal aerial movement to fuck shit up. Boom, go in on it. Alright, I'm going ham on it. Now I'm gonna fly up, gonna pop it, and then I'm gonna pick up nice close enough to getting a double kill. Close enough to getting a double kill. Until he heals himself. I get turned into a chicken. I get shredded. I have a weird glitch going on. I don't know what that's all about. Of course, I'm just explaining shit to you now. Now, get ready for the coup de grace. The ending of the match. Of course, this isn't like, you know, next round is the end. But obviously, you can see my team's clustered together. That's good, but that's bad. Because all the blast damage is going to fuck them up. Luckily, me, knowing that my team's composition, how they are clustering together... Since I'm astray from them, they're not going to have time to really focus on counting how many heads they're shooting at. They're too busy seeing a hail of bullets a cannon, a hook, and a 13-year-old shooting a rocket launcher staff at them to really care about. That's five people. That's four people standing there, not five. Where the hell is the fifth person? You know? Of course, now that I counted here, I think there's six players. No, there's five. There's five in this game. Never mind. I don't know. I'm a bit... There's six in Overwatch, five in this game. I get that confused all the time. Only because, you know, the games are very similar, a lot of people say. And yes, they're both hero shooters, hence why they're similar. So yeah, you'll see this, alright? Boom, don't go for the flank. I go straight for the flank, you know. But the thing is that their healer went for the flank. Dumb move. Very dumb move indeed. But it's advantageous for me because, you know, shit happens. Like I said, back's turn. They don't know what the fuck's going on. And, you know, this is ridiculous. Like, just look at this shit. They're not even trying. They just don't know. They do not know. Alright, now I'm just gonna stand here, obviously, you know, I'm like, to pat myself in the back, say, hey, good shit, you know. You know, that was very NATO. Oh, well then, ain't he dead? Yeah, he's dead. He's extra dead. Now watch, just shoot him, keep my distance, because Torvald can silence me, believe it or not. Boom, get the burst off. You get the burst off, that's good, alright? Luckily that Makoa knew the shield shit. He shielded shit pretty good. Silence, boom, pick up the kill. Real easy. Defiance is a better version of Fanta Hammer, in my opinion. Getting grenaded. Oh, hey, look, it's a furry. Now he's dead. Alright, good time to taunt. That's a sweet victory right there. Pretty good to me. So, and for some reason, overtime just occurred three times in a row. Boom. And that was pretty easy. Pretty smooth. Pretty silky. So, yeah, more or less, I would say build Defiance. Build a Defiance build is one of the most gambit builds you can ever have in the game. But if you can clutch it out and you know how to use Defiance properly and you understand its properties, then you can use it to the maximum of, you know, his kit. Because unlike a lot of heroes, Androxus, his ult fire, his Defiance, has no cooldown. Therefore, when using it, is quite powerful.